Hello friends, welcome to the session on discrete mathematics. In this session, we'll be discussing about relation and function. In this session, we will see what we mean by relation, what are the different types of relation, what is the Cartesian product of the two sets. Also, we will define a function and the different types of functions. Friends, as you know that you are viewing this session on my YouTube channel, and do subscribe to the channel to see many other videos on the various topics of the subjects of electronics and computer science. So let us start the session with the question, what we mean by a relation. One can easily observe that in our daily routine lives, the two human beings always have certain kind of relation. Say, for example, we can have the relation such as brother and sister. We can have the relation such as father and son. We can have the relation such as teacher and a student. So whenever we live our life, then the human beings always have certain kind of relationship among each other. In computers, we make the use of the sets. And whenever we consider any two given sets, then it is possible that you can define a certain relation between the two sets. And this relation R is actually a kind of subset of the given two sets. A relation R from the set A to the set B can be shown through the Cartesian product A cross B. So whenever we consider the two sets and there is some kind of relationship between the elements of the first set to the elements of the second set, then that can be called as a relation between the two sets. Relations are used to define the kind of connectivity between the two sets. So whenever there is a kind of connection between the two sets, then this connection can be described by using the relation. There are different types of relations such as universal relation, identity relation, inverse relation, reflexive relation, symmetric relation, equivalence relation. So whenever we are able to define the relation between the two sets, then there can be a variety of type of relation. A relation can also be said as a set of ordered pairs, where the first element is from the first set and the second element is from the second set. Relations are useful in computers because whenever we describe computer languages or whenever we describe the compiler grammar, then for such a description, we can make the use of relations. Also in data structures, relations are used. Say for example, whenever we want to perform the graph traversal, that is whenever we want to visit each and every element of the graph, then relation can be used. Relations are also used in databases in order to describe the relational databases. So before going for the definition of the relation, let us understand what we mean by the Cartesian products of the two sets. Suppose we have been given a set A and we have been given a set B, then it is possible that from these two sets, we can obtain a third set A cross B. And this set is being called as the Cartesian product of the two sets A and B. So the Cartesian product A cross B is the set of all ordered pairs of elements of A and B. So for example, if A is consisting of two elements, 1 and 2, and B is consisting of three elements, 3, 4, and 5, then A cross B is a set of ordered pairs such as 1, 3, 1, 4, 1, 5, 2, 3, 2, 4, and 2, 5. That is, A cross B is a set of all ordered pairs A comma B, where A belongs to capital A and B belongs to capital B. It is also possible that you can take the Cartesian product of B and A, that is B cross A, and this is a set of ordered pairs 3, 1, 3, 2, 4, 1, 4, 2, 5, 1, and 5, 2. So one can easily observe that the Cartesian product of A and B is not equal to the Cartesian product of B and A, because both these sets are different. If A is equal to phi or B is equal to phi, that is a null set, then in that case A cross B is equal to B cross A is equal to phi. The number of elements in the Cartesian product of A and B is written as n of A cross B, which is just nothing but n A into n B. Say for example, if A consists of two elements and B consists of three elements, then the number of elements in the A cross B will be 2 into 3, that is 6. By using the Cartesian product, actually what we are doing is that we have been given the two different set, and from the two different set we are obtaining a third set. So we are obtaining one set from the two sets. Cartesian product is very useful operation, because by making the use of the Cartesian product we can perform matrix applications. Also, by using the Cartesian product, it is possible that we can define the relation between the two sets. Now let us go for the definition of relation, domain and range. Suppose A and B are the two sets, then the relation R from A to B is actually a subset of the Cartesian product A cross B. Suppose we have been given a set A consisting of elements 2, 4, 5, 6, 7, and B is the another set consisting of elements 2 and 3, then the relation R can be defined as R is equal to the collection of ordered pairs A, B, where A belongs to A, B belongs to B, and A is divisible by B. So this is the relation between the sets A and B. And therefore R will consist of the elements 2, 2, 4, 2, 6, 2, and 6, 3. That is, we have to consider only those ordered pairs in which A is divisible by B. If the relation R is equal to phi, then R can be called as a void relation. If the relation R is equal to A cross B, that is the Cartesian product of A and B, then the relation R is being called universal relation. If R is a relation from A to A itself, then it is being called as a relation defined on A itself. If R is equal to A, A, for each A belongs to the capital A, then R is to be called as the identity relation. Now we can define the domain of a relation. If R is a relation between the two sets A and B, then the set of the first element of all ordered pairs of R is called as a domain. So as far as this relation is concerned, when we consider the first element of these ordered pairs, that is R is equal to 2, 4 and 6, then that is to be called as a domain of the relation. The range of the relation is defined as the set of the second elements of all ordered pairs of R, and it is being called as a range. Say for example, for this relation R, the second element is 2, 2, 2 and 3, and therefore the range can be defined as 2, 3. So it is possible that graphically you can define this relation. This is the set A consisting of the elements 2, 4, 5, 6, 7. This is the set B consisting of elements 2 and 3. And when you draw this mapping, then this is the relation R. The relation R is from A to B, and in this case we can call the set B as the codomain for R. Now let us go for the definition of a function. The relation F from the set A to the set B, where every element of A has a unique image in B, is being called as a function from A to B. Suppose we have a set A consisting of the elements A, B, C, D. We have a set B consisting of elements 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And if each and every element from the set A has a unique image in the set B, then that can be called as a function. In a function, no two ordered pairs will have the same first element. So it is possible that they can have the same second element, but the first element should be unique for each ordered pair. Set B is to be termed as a codomain. And whenever we want to write a function, then we can write the function f colon a to b. So a arrow b. So this is a way of writing the function. It is also possible that you can describe the function graphically also. Say, for example, when we consider the function y is equal to x square, then for the different values of x, we can compute the value of y. And when we plot them and when we connect all such points, then we can represent graphically the function. Also, in this example, you will find that the first figure is not a function because the element B do not have any image. Then the second figure is also not a function because the element C has the multiple images. The figure C is a function because it satisfies the basic definition of function. Also, the figure D is a function because it satisfies the basic definition of the function. In real life or in mathematics, you will find that there are different types of functions. Say, for example, we can have an identity function where f of a is equal to b is equal to a. Such a function is represented by a straight line. Also, we can have a constant function f of a is equal to b is equal to some constant value, which is a horizontal line. Also, whenever you have been given any polynomial expression, then we can draw the polynomial function. Also, we can be given a quadratic equation such as a square minus 4, b is equal to a square minus 4, then we can draw the quadratic function. Whenever we have been given a cubic function, then we can draw the function as shown in this diagram, where f of a is equal to a cube minus 5. The rational function or the modulus function can also be represented graphically. So thank you, friends, for viewing the session. Hopefully you have understood what we mean by relation and function in discrete mathematics. Thank you all.